Welcome, dear students. We have solved two problems in formation of steam chapter. In today's class, we will be taking one more problem. So let us take that problem. Let me read out the problem to you. A sample of 1 kg of steam at a pressure of 15 bar exists in following two conditions. So what he has given? He has given a sample of steam at 15 bar and it is existing in two conditions. 15 kg steam hai hamare paas, 1 kg 15 bar pressure ka steam hai hamare paas aur 1 kg steam hai and it is existing in two conditions. So what are those two conditions? Let us see. First condition, wet steam with dryness fraction 0.8. So he has given us the value of dryness fraction as 0.8. Then second condition, superheated steam with a temperature of 215 degree centigrade. So steam is been superheated to a temperature of 215 degree centigrade. Then what are the things we need to find out? Determine the following properties in each case. So what are those properties we need to find out? First one, enthalpy. Second one, specific volume. Then the third one, entropy. The fourth one, external work. And fifth one, internal energy for both these cases. Take the specific heat of superheated steam as 2.3 kilojoules per kg Kelvin. Neglect the volume of water. So he has asked us to neglect the volume of water and he has given us the specific heat of superheated steam as 2.3 kilojoules per kg Kelvin. This is a problem given to us. Now let us write the things given in the problem first. So he has given the steam at a pressure of P equal to 15 bar. So pressure is 15 bar. Then at a given pressure of 15 bar from steam table, that is, I have told you last class, it is table number 2, we need to refer where the table is pertaining to pressure. So at 15 bar pressure, at P equal to 15 bar, HF is 845 kilojoules per kg. HFG 1947 kilojoules per kg. Then saturation temperature corresponding to a pressure of 15 bar is 198.3 degree centigrade. Then SF value is 2.315 kilojoules per kg Kelvin. Then SFG is 4.154 kilojoules per kg Kelvin. Then VG, that is specific volume of dry saturated steam, is 1.317 meter cube per kg. So these are the things that are taken from the steam table. Now let us take the first case, that is for wet steam with dryness fraction x equal to 0.8. So when dryness fraction is 0.8, right, let us take this first case and find out the terms. That is, A, first you have to find out enthalpy. H will be equal to HF plus XHFG. I repeat, H equal to HF plus XHFG. So what is the value of HF? It is 845, X is 0.8 and HFG is 1947. So calculate it. Upon calculating, you will get the answer as 2402.6 kilojoules per kg. Then find out second case, find out specific volume. So I'll write 2, specific volume will be equal to, that is Vs. Vs will be equal to x into Vg. I repeat, Vs will be equal to x into Vg. So what is the value of x? X is 0.8 into Vg is 0.1317. So use a calculator, calculate it, you will get the answer as 1053 or 10536 or 1054 meter cube per kg. Then the third term what you have to find out is entropy, that is specific entropy. Specific entropy. Specific entropy S equal to SF plus XSFG. So SF value is known, that is 2.315 kilojoules per kg Kelvin, plus X is known, it is 0.8 into SFG is 4.154. All these values we have found out from the steam table. Then find out this specific entropy. So calculate it. So we get the answer as 5.638 kilojoules per kg Kelvin. We are writing it per kg, so it is specific entropy. Then next, find out for wet steam with dryness fraction x equal to 0.8. Find out next external work W equal to, we know the equation, it is 100 P into X into Vg. P into X into Vg multiply by 100. So you are converting this bar into Newton per meter square. So 100, pressure given is 15, X is 0.8 into Vg is 0.1317. So calculate this using calculator, you will get the answer as 158.04 kilojoules per kg. This is external work. Then find out internal energy. So internal energy U will be equal to H minus W, which we have already found out, that is enthalpy, and W is external work. So enthalpy what you have got is 2402.6 minus W is 158.04. So calculate this, you will get the answer as 2244.56 kilojoules per kg. This is for first case, that is when the steam is wet with the dryness fraction x equal to 0.8. Then case 2. So what is that case 2? For superheated steam with temperature, that is superheated temperature is 215 degree centigrade. So superheated temperature is 215 degree centigrade given to us. So for this temperature we need to find out all these five parameters, starting with enthalpy. That is first one enthalpy H superheated will be equal to Hg plus Cps into bracket T sup minus T sat. This is the equation for finding out the enthalpy of superheated steam. So what is the value of Hg? Hg is nothing but Hf plus Hfg plus Cps into bracket T sup minus T sat. So what is the value of Hf? Hf is 845 plus Hfg is 1947 plus Cps is known to us, it is 2.3. into bracket superheated temperature is known, it is 215 degree centigrade minus what is the saturation temperature, it is 198.3 degree centigrade. So substitute these values in the equation and then calculate the value of enthalpy. So upon calculating you will get the answer as 2830.41 kilojoules per kg. This is the enthalpy of superheated steam. Next, second case, that is specific volume. So let us find out the specific volume of superheated steam. How to find out the specific volume of superheated steam? That is Vg divided by Tsat will be equal to V soup divided by T soup. Because the pressure is constant, you are using the PVT relationship, pressure being constant. So Vg is nothing but Vsat. Specific volume of saturated, dry saturated steam divided by temperature of dry saturated steam will be equal to specific volume of superheated steam divided by temperature of superheated steam. So therefore V soup will be equal to Vg into T superheated divided by T saturated. I repeat, V superheated will be equal to Vg multiplied by this T superheated will go to the numerator divided by T saturated. So substitute these values, substitute all the values of this in the equation. That is, the value of Vg is 0.1317 into, now you have to be very very careful when you are substituting the temperature of superheated steam. It has to be, for this we need to add 273. Please keep that in mind. For this temperature we need to add 273. So 215 plus 273. You can add here only, or before that only you can add the answer. That is, upon adding, divided by T saturated, again same, 198.3 plus 273 in the denominator. Don't cancel 273. It is in the bracket, so you have to add these two. So the equation is Vg by capital T sat equal to V soup divided by T sat. T is absolute temperature. I repeat, T is absolute temperature. Now calculate, you will get the answer as 0.1349 meter cube per kg is the value of Vg. Then third case, find out specific entropy. Specific entropy of superheated steam is given by the equation S soup is equal to Sg plus 2.3 log of T soup divided by T sat. That is, Sg value we know directly, you can find out the value of Sg. Sg is Sf plus Sfg, which we have already found out. We can find out directly, by adding. That is Sf plus Sfg plus 2.3 log of T soup by T sat. That is, you add the value of Sf. Sf is 2.315. Sfg is 4.154 plus 2.3 log of, again this is, these are absolute temperatures. So 215 plus 273 divided by 198.3 plus 273. Again I repeat, we make a mistake by not adding 273 to both these temperatures. Here these temperatures are absolute, so we need to add 273 to these two terms. Then therefore calculate, you will get the answer as 6.524 kilojoules per kg. Then fourth one, we need to find out external external work W will be equal to 100 P into V superheated. That is 100, P is 15 bar, V superheated just now we have found out, that is 0.1349. That is, calculate, you will get the answer as 202.35 kilojoules per kg. Then find out internal energy. So internal energy U will be equal to H sup minus W, that is 2830.41, which you have found out the enthalpy of superheated steam, minus 202.35, that is external work of evaporation, subtract it, we will get the answer as 2628.06 kilojoules per kg. So what we have done, we have taken a problem where we need to find out enthalpy, specific volume, specific entropy, external work and internal energy for the first case when the steam is wet with a dryness fraction of 0.8, and second case we have done when the steam is superheated to a temperature of 215 degrees centigrade. So in the next class we will take few more problems. Thank you.